everybody. Everybody, I'm back. Everybody, Gina Young is back, and I'm back with yet another amazing recipe. I am so excited today because today at the Young's house, Gina Young is going to share with you all how easy it is to make a delicious maple honey glazed ham. This recipe right here, it's so easy. It doesn't require a lot of ingredients, and you know, making Gina Young style, it's gonna be so tasty. Y'all never had my maple honey glazed ham. You better make you some. Here are the lovely ingredients you will need. Of course, you're gonna need some ham. Now, when I go out and purchase a ham for the holidays, this is what I like to get. So today I have the Sugardale spiced spiral sliced ham that is fully cooked. Okay, so that's what we'll be using today. You will need some honey. You're gonna need some pure maple syrup. You will need either brown sugar or white sugar. Today I'm gonna use the brown sugar. You will also need a couple of spices so we can spice everything up. Here's what you'll need over this way. You will need some maple extract, some vanilla extract, cinnamon, and allspice. And there's one other ingredient that I need to get out of the refrigerator, which it's never too late. We're gonna use a stick of butter. Make sure your hands are impeccably clean. Let's get started with this really quick and simple, yet so tasty recipe. Okay, everyone. So the first thing that I wanna do is talk about the size baking pan that we're gonna use. We're just gonna use a regular cake pan. The size is a 12x9. I love to use a disposable because when you're done, you can just dispose of it. So now, I have washed my ham off just with some cold water, and then I've pat it dry with a paper towel. So one of the first things that we need to do is we need to make a glaze, and we're gonna take that glaze and we're gonna put it between all of these beautiful layers that have already been cut for us. Okay, so make sure when you go out and purchase your ham, you go out and get the kind that's already spiral sliced. So now in this bowl, I have 3 tablespoons of melted butter. I just nuked it in the microwave for 10 seconds. Okay, so now I wanna take some pure maple syrup. We're gonna put it right in to our butter. Okay, it's gonna be about a half a cup, all right? Between the maple syrup and the honey. If you just wanted to do honey, that's fine. You can just do honey and butter, or if you just wanna do maple and butter, that's fine as well. So now that we have our gorgeous honey and our maple syrup glazed, that's mixed with the melted butter, we wanna go ahead and give it a nice whisk just like this. Oh, listen. You can taste it right now. The smell is amazing. You know this is gonna be delicious. You know what, this recipe, it's so easy, it's so much fun, and I cannot wait to hear the comments when you make this recipe. When I come back, I'm gonna show you how to baste this maple honey glaze onto your ham. I hope you all are having an amazing weekend. Let me know in the comment section below if you've ever tasted honey baked ham, because that's what this ham is gonna taste like when you make it. You know, you don't have to use the maple, but for some reason, I love to use the maple, and when I use it, my family members, they go nuts over this. Okay, so I have a pastry brush here, and I just want to, look at that. Ooh, baby, uh-huh. That's what I want to do. You can paint it all over the top. Okay, we're going to do just like that. And then we're going to take our time to go in between each and every layer or each and every slice. And don't pull it open too much because you don't want it to fall apart in your oven. But you go between every single slice and you get that honey maple butter glaze down into your gorgeous ham. When I come back, I'm going to do this whole ham. When I come back, I'll show you what we'll do next. Okay, everyone. So now that we've glazed this beautiful ham with the maple syrup, honey, and butter, let's transfer our ham into the pan. Now, here's what I like to do, and I think this is very important. If you put your ham in your pan like this, guess what's gonna happen? Oh, all of those slices are gonna start opening and falling apart. I don't want that to happen. I want it to remain nice and beautiful, so here's what we're gonna do. We have our pan here. we're going to just take it this way and set our ham just like so. Okay, and then I'm going to take that honey maple and butter glaze and we're going to pour it all over the top. We're not going to waste any of that goodness. Okay, now I do have my oven preheated to 375 degrees. Keep in mind, when you purchase a ham that's fully cooked, all you need to do is heat it up. Okay, but now a lot of people want to know, okay, so exactly how long do I cook it? Cook it 10 minutes per pound. Okay, but like I said, you really just need to heat it fully through. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take some aluminum foil. We're going to cover this bad boy. We're going to make somewhat of a tent. So you're going to need a nice amount of foil. We're going to get this in the oven. Once it starts getting nice and warm, I'll come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so you can see that we have wrapped our ham in foil. And I do want to talk about my pan. I did a switch up. I do have a roasting pan here. And I decided to switch because my ham is so heavy. When I went to lift up my 12 by 9, it was quite flimsy. So I switched to this roaster. This is going in the oven, 375 degrees. When I come back, I'm going to show you how to make this sugar mixture that's going to send this ham over the top. Okay, everyone, so let's talk about this really quickly. Your ham that you purchase, just like the ham that I purchased, will come with, some of them come with a packet for glaze. Okay, it's a really simple glaze that you could use. And what they require, let me see. They ask you to take this packet, put it in a saucepan with 1.5 teaspoons of water. You just mix it up, it's a glaze, you can put it on top of your ham. But we're not gonna use it. We're not gonna use it. And the reason why I don't wanna use it is because it has ingredients in it that I'm not also familiar with. So it does tell you that it has brown sugar in it, which is awesome. We're gonna use brown sugar. It does have powdered sugar. We're not gonna use that. It has spices. We are gonna put our own spices in. It has honey powder, which is really interesting. But then it goes on about saying they have silicone dioxin in it and a couple other things that I cannot pronounce. So we're not gonna use it. Have I used it in the past? Yes, I have, and it's delicious. All right, but here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take some brown sugar. This part is amazing. This is that packet on steroids. Okay, so we wanna get 2 cups of sugar, all right? 2 cups of brown sugar, there's 1 cup. And then we'll do a 2nd cup. Don't make a mess like I did. All right, so now that we have our brown sugar, let me put my sugar here and wipe the sugar off my hands. All right, now what we're gonna do is we wanna season up the sugar, okay? So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take some of that allspice. If you're a person that loves nutmeg, use you some. Don't use too much allspice, it can be overwhelming. Okay, that much, let me see. That much will do the trick. And cinnamon, you can never have enough. Get you some cinnamon in there, just like so. And then what I wanna do is I wanna give it a nice stir, just like so, just until all of those spices are well combined. Our ham is in the oven, 375 degrees. Once it starts to get nice and warm in the inside, I'll come back and show you what to do next. Okay, everyone. So now that we have our mixture here, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take the rest of the butter. We've taken 3 tablespoons off of the stick of butter. We're gonna take the rest and put it right here into a pan. And this right here is gonna be a glaze that we're gonna baste on like every 15 minutes. And that's definitely a must if you wanna get that sticky, ooey gooey glaze on the top of your ham. Here's how we're gonna do it. Here's where the maple extract and the vanilla extract comes into play. Let's go ahead and take our butter, and you can use the honey alone, or you can use the maple alone, or use the two together like I'm gonna do. So here's our maple, get you some in there. Don't just go out and use pancake syrup. That's not what I'm asking you guys to do. Get you some maple syrup. It's gonna, oh, listen, it's gonna be delicious. Okay, so now that we have that on, we did use 2 cups of the brown sugar. 1 cup of the brown sugar is gonna go right into this mixture. The other cup of this mixture is gonna go right on top of the ham, and I'll tell you the perfect time to put this on your ham. We're gonna wait for this butter to melt down and everything to marry all together, and I'll come back and I'll show you what the consistency should look like. Okay, everyone, so I want you all to take a look at this amazing glaze. Now, once your butter starts to melt and marry with the honey and the maple syrup, this is what it will look like. So, and you wanna start to see a little bit of boiling. And you can see that boiling starting to happen right there. I'm very pleased with that. So we're gonna go in with that maple extract. Oh yeah, don't worry about that. That's gonna naturally happen. And we're gonna put some vanilla in, just like so. Great flavor right there. And honestly, we're gonna stir this around for about a minute or so. Then we're gonna turn this off. This is your glaze that we're gonna baste on the ham every 15 minutes. So in a half an hour, I'm gonna come back and we'll start our basting process. When I baste my ham, I usually baste it 2 or 3 times. Most of the time it's 2 times. Okay, everyone, here is Prince and Polo. You all asked about them. We have Polo on the left and Prince on the right. On the 16th, they'll be going to get groomed. I can't wait because they really need to be groomed. Their hair needs to be cut. I couldn't be more excited for this recipe right here. This right here is definitely a ham that you're gonna wanna put on your dinner table for Christmas or New Year's, Thanksgiving, or just whenever. It's so much fun and it's delicious. Now let's get to basting. This cooked in the oven for 45 minutes, and when I put my finger in the middle of the ham, it's nice and warm. So it's all warm all throughout. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Remember that glaze that we made? Take a look at it. Oh yeah, and it thickened up a bit. Okay, we're gonna give it a nice swirly swirl, and here's what we're gonna do. Let's mix it up really good. We're gonna take it, we're gonna do the same thing. Oh yeah, just baste it on, you hear me? Let it drizzle down this side. Along the sides, we're gonna paint it once again. We're gonna open up the inside and let that beautiful glaze go all throughout. And then also, we're gonna do something else after I get this fully coated. We're gonna go into this here, and I'm gonna show you how to apply this to get this amazing crust that you all love when you think about a nice, beautiful honey-baked ham, except it's Gina Young style. Okay, before we go any further, I just have to mention that I am so excited about my sweatshirt today. You all, every single video, you all say, Gina, where do you get your clothes from? I love the shirts. And I know I never answer because I don't know, because I have a personal stylist. And that personal stylist is my husband. He knows what I like. He knows what style looks nice on me because I don't know. I'm a mess when I go to the store. When I go to the store, it's like turning in circles. But he knows what looks nice on me. He brings it home. And what I love about it is he'll tell me, now listen, we're gonna try it on. If you don't like it, I'll take it back. And that's like the best feeling in the world. I don't mind taking it back. Just make sure you like it. And I love all of the shirts. You all love it. But I am so happy with this shirt today. I'll do a little twisty twist so y'all can see the back. All right, getting back to our ham. Here's what we need to do. So now we're going to take this right here. And we're just going to put it on the top just like so. And I've turned that oven up to 425 degrees. Now, I want you all to stay close by to the oven. Reason why is because this glaze has a potential to burn. You do want to get a nice, beautiful, dark golden brown glaze to it, but you don't want it burnt. You know, you all know the look that we're looking for. So now that we've done this, let's get it back into the oven. 425 degrees. When I come back, I'll show you what we'll do next. I'm going to say an amazing prayer. You all are going to get that first bite. Okay, everybody, take a look at it. Gina Young style maple honey glazed baked ham. Make you some. I'm gonna turn it around so y'all can see all around this beautifulness. And it does look like a piece is missing. That's because it is. That whole piece right there, I've ate that. All right, keep on looking. We're gonna keep on turning just like so. Oh yes, beautiful. Okay, everyone, so I did the second baste off camera. So we did baste this with the glaze. One more time off camera, and also with a little bit more of the brown sugar, and I stayed exactly right beside that oven so that we didn't get, you know, too burnt. So how long did it cook? It cooked with the second set of glaze on it just for about 3 minutes. That's all we needed. Listen here, everybody. If you all enjoyed this here video, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you click on that notification bell so you can be notified every time Gina Young uploads one of these awesome recipes. Tell your family and friends and everyone you know. Tell the whole world about Gina Young and what I'm doing in this kitchen on a daily basis. Let's say a really quick prayer. You all are gonna get that first bite. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, I wanna thank you for a beautiful day today. Lord, we thank you for your love time, your mercy and your understanding. Please forgive us for our sins. Come into our hearts. We make you our Lord and Savior. Send your angels down to surround us day and night. Your Holy Spirit to help us make good decisions. Give us peace over our minds in the name of Jesus. We pray that no weapons formed against us shall prosper. We bind the devil away from us in Jesus' name. Let that devil know he has no authority over this household. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the roof over our head, the food, the love, peace and the joy. Amen. Amen. Once again to my beautiful prayer. Let's take a bite. I can't wait any longer. Let's go. Oh, it's hot, but I don't care. Ooh, I don't care. Ooh, burn my fingers off. You hear me? All right. Let's take a nice bite of this. And, you know, don't overcook your ham. It's the worst thing that you can do. There's nothing like a nice dried ham. It's horrible. Don't cook it too long. Remember, this is already cooked. You just want to heat it through. Look at how juicy this is. Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure you can see it. It's nice and juicy. Take a bite. I'm going in. I'm going in. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna give you a bite of that glaze. Man. And as always, God bless you all. Thank you all for watching. One more bite. Good night.